for a researcher thinking about how they can apply PRS effectively, so there are a range of different considerations. So first of all, some diseases are much more heritable or genetic than others, and so obviously the more heritable the disease, the higher the potential of the polygenic risk scores. Although even if a disease is highly genetic and environmental factors play a limited role, you still need to have mapped enough of the genes.
In order to identify genes associated with complex diseases, we need to perform what's called genome-wide association studies. So these are typically very large-scale studies where we investigate thousands of individuals who have the disease and then compare their genome against thousands of healthy control individuals.
It's really necessary to carry out the large-scale GWAS studies of different populations, different ethnicities, because we've already learned that the frequency of variants are quite different among different populations. We need abundant data, the big data, large sample size, maybe more than 10,000, even 100,000 sample sizes GWAS data for a reference.
It's become very clear what you need to do in order to generate a useful polygenic risk score. You essentially need to genotype enough cases so that you discover 100 or 200 GWAS loci. For most disorders, this means genotyping somewhere between 30,000 and 150,000 cases. However, once you can achieve that, the polygenic risk score that you derive can then be used in much smaller samples and in some cases in individuals.